Derek, TonyVarsitySportsNetwork.com. We're here at Milford Mill Academy for some preseason football action. It was South River versus Milford Mill Academy. In 2018, the Seahawks of South River went 7-5. They pulled off one of the big upsets as far as around the area. They knocked off defending Anne Arundel County champ and previously undefeated Broadneck in the Class 4A East Region semifinals. Their season ended against a very good North Point team, but that was just fuel to the fire as they looked to build momentum in 2019 as they looked to contend for the Anne Arundel County Championship. And Coach Ed Dolch is in front, is here with me now. And Coach, just talk about just the off season and the preseason so far.
The off season's been fantastic. The kids are obviously excited. There's a lot of enthusiasm surrounding the program coming off of a successful season like we had last year. So the kids are really bought into what we're trying to do, and we're kind of preaching them right now. Not getting complacent. Last year can't be good enough. There's another level that we want to take this to. And all the work that we put in to get to the region championship and make appearance last year, it's going to take more work. The easy part's done. The foundation's laid. It's going to take more work. Every step along the way now is even harder to beat a team like North Point. Those teams that are competing for state championships every year, and to put yourself on that level is a tall task. So we can't rest on what we did last year. We've got to continue to put in the work, continue to get better.
Right. Let's talk about some of the parts of that foundation on the offensive, and talk about some kids you're excited about having back and some new faces that
We're in a little bit of a different situation than we were last year. We bring back majority of our skilled position players, which was not the case last year. So all four wideouts are coming back that we had on the perimeter. David comes back as our quarterback. We have a few new faces in the backfield. Delvin Johnson was with the varsity last year, played a small role in the offense. Now he's going to step into a larger role. Andy Foy is going to step in for his older brother. Lala Tito, a kid from Spalding, transferred over. And then Asa Evans is a football line short yard. We have four backs that we trust, which is something that we haven't been able to say in the past. So skill-wise, we are very confident in those guys. Up front, we're replacing some pretty good players who have departed, obviously, with Karan. But we have some young guys who we think we're gonna grow into that mold, that are gonna get thrown into the fire. But the quicker we can get those right and get those guys playing together as a unit, I think our offense is gonna be pretty dangerous, led by some of those experienced guys on the outside.
Yeah, and you have the perfect trigger man in Dave Falls. Talk about him and just how he's now one of the top senior quarterbacks in this region.
Yeah, he's today was a very encouraging day as far as Dave's concerned. You know, he's been with us on the varsity as a freshman, soaking up the system. Last year was his first time as a full-time starter. With him coming back, he's got like a 4.5 GPA. He's an intelligent kid, huge arm talent. We're putting a lot on his plate. I'm getting the calls on, but he's got the green light to change some things, check some things, and take advantage of things that he's seeing on the field. So he's an extension of me out there. Like I said, this was a very encouraging day because he saw some things, adjusted some things, and made a lot of great reads and made some plays out here for us. So, me doing that and having that relationship with him is obvious display of the trust I have in him.
Right. Talk about the defensive side of the ball.
Defense, up front, and linebacking core, and we expect to be extremely physical, fly around to the football. We're going to be a blitz-heavy team, kind of what you saw here today. We want to get off the quarterback, get him off his mark, make things uncomfortable in the pocket. And we're not the biggest, fastest team in the world when we get off the bus. So we got to rally 11 hats. So that's what we're preaching every day, all day in practice, rallying to the football, flying around. You kind of overcome those physical challenges of not being the bigger, faster guy by playing harder than the other guy, using good techniques. So. Secondary wise, just like I said, with the receivers and the skill positions, we're deeper than we have ever been in years past. So we have about eight guys in the secondary that we're sorting through that we trust that can step in and get the job done. So that's the biggest challenge for us as a coaching staff, which is something new, is how we handle all this depth, because in years past it's been pretty clear who our ones are, who our twos are, and there's been a pretty big drop off between those two units. This year there's a lot of guys vying for playing time and kind of chopping up a bit. So we're going to take this film home and talk as a staff and start to sort out those personnel packages and things like that going forward.
Right. And talk a little bit about your special teams.
Special teams, a little bit of a work in progress. Obviously, we controlled the scrimmage setting We don't do a whole lot of kicking and things like that. So we put together our field goal PAT unit, our block stuff in preparation for today. We have a circuit that we go through each day, but starting on Monday when we hit the field again, we will obviously start putting together those units, identifying our personnel and putting together depth charts in that regard. So by next week, our special teams should be pretty solid.
Well, just talk about last year. Again, you know, the successful playoff run and then kind of changing the profile of South River football.
Yeah, I guess the first thing I have to do is give credit to the seniors that graduated last year and really put in the effort to turn this program around and put it in a better place than they found it. So I was blessed to coach guys like Karan, Joe Foy, and Nate Carball who were all in on football, did everything that we asked, and really took this thing to another level. So the credit goes to those players. We're fortunate to have a great senior class coming back who are ready to take that torch and hopefully even carry it to another level. So, you know, guys like Dave, Sean, Nasir, guys who we consider leaders of our team. They say the best teams, the best players are the hardest workers, and those guys are all 3.5 and above GPAs. They're where they're supposed to be, and they make my life very easy as a coach when you have those kind of leaders in the locker room and in the hallway.
Right, right. Three keys to success for South River football in 2019, coach.
Cool. Pretty much the same thing that we always say, I guess. We always want to minimize our penalties. We want to win the turnover battle, and we've got to play with better technique and better effort than our opponent. On every snap, we've got to be locked in. So our attention to detail is kind of the thing that gets us over the hump. Because like I said, we're not going to be bigger and faster all the time, so we've got to overcome those deficiencies by outworking and out-executing our opponent. You know, that's kind of the formula for the success that we had last year, and hopefully our guys are buying into that identity again this year, and it helps us along the way again.
All right, well, Ed Dolch and this South River Seahawk football team, they are getting ready for their 2019 opener, just a couple of weeks away against Westminster as they look to contend for the Howard and Arundel, District 5 though, I mean, whatever, and the Arundel County Championship. For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Tony.